First in the Morning with Bob Montgomery and Leanne Tokars.
A Christmas wish for some coming true, golfing in December. The recent warm weather allowing golfers the chance to hit the course. Judy Creek's general manager says it's been packed the past few days. Yesterday was the first time since 2011 it was open on Christmas Eve. And while it was foggy, golfers were happy to be out.
I can't see as it is, so I'll probably lose my ball in the fog anyway. Probably better the way I hit it, but yeah, like I said, I'd be inside and nice to be outside and doing something we enjoy doing.
The course will be open as long as weather permits. And while we have some fog again this morning, we're tracking another warm day. WSBT 22 Chief Meteorologist Matt Rudkin is here. Matt, this is going down as one of the warmest Christmases in our area.
Yeah, on record. Yeah. Crazy. It's been since the early 80s since we've seen anything remotely similar to this warm. So hopefully you have the opportunity to get outside and enjoy it. I know a lot of you, myself included, wish we had a little snow for Christmas. But if we're not going to have it, this is the way to do it, right? Not 35 and drizzle. We're talking mid-50s, potentially upper 50s with some sunshine. Pretty awesome for Christmas time. Here's a live look in Winona Lake. Gotta mention, too, my good friend Jamie over at Swiss Valley Message. They are open later today, and they've got about 20 inches of snow thanks to some overnight snowmaking and a really hard-working crew up that way. So check them out if you're looking for some snow. It's a good place to go. Southwest Michigan has got some snow for you. Here's a live look in St. Joe. No snow up that way. But again, it's not a ski resort, right? We'll get some. Don't worry about it. It'll eventually come here. Just timing's kind of off this year. Visibility not too bad out there. When you're above 1 mile visibility as far as driving, no real issues. The airports are doing okay as well. Just checked on flights out of South Bend, Midway, Chicago, and Detroit. Everybody's looking pretty good around our region. Temperatures out there already in the mid-30s. We'll get into the mid-50s later today. It's the warmest since 1982. Today, Christmas is not the only day where we're going to be this warm. We'll chat about more warmth before signs of winter a little bit showing up in your forecast in just a little while.
Matt, thank you. Here at WSBT, we aren't the only ones at work during the holidays. Firefighters, police, and EMTs are still on the roads, and their dispatch centers still need to be fully staffed. WSBT 22's Selena Guevara learned how one 911 call center is keeping it cheery today.
Coming in, you've got four of them up there.
At any given time, about 15 people are manning the phones at the St. Joseph County Call Center, even overnight on Christmas Eve. Normally, people have 8-hour shifts, but several people have been working 12 hours to make up for coworkers' vacations during the holidays.
It is a little crazy just because everyone's being exhausted already with the overtime to cover the vacations and the time off, but we're getting it covered.
One of the workers mentioned that people always think to bring food to firefighters and police officers on the holidays, but don't always remember the people behind the scenes. But they deal with stressful jobs and know how to look out for each other.
Yep, we try to make everybody cheery.
Potluck food, cheery costumes, and a door decorating competition between the shift crews. This Grinch ended up winning the best design. As for the phones, this Christmas Eve started out a bit slower than years past.
It's probably about normal, only because it's not snowing outside right now. With that, then that people are traveling, gonna have more accidents, but it's pretty mellow right now.
And even though the workers aren't with their blood family, it still feels like home for the holidays.
For the most part, it's our second family. It's our home away from home.
Selena Guevara, WSBT 22 News.
Selena, thank you. Happening right now, police in Indianapolis offering a $10,000 reward for information that could lead to the arrests of two men who robbed a mailman. Police say the man approached the mail carrier and stopped his truck. One of them showed the worker he had a gun and demanded all of the mail in the vehicle. The Postal Inspection Service says mail around Christmas time may have more valuable goods in it, but robberies like this one aren't exclusive to the holiday season. They say it happens an average of once a month, and there's no way for mail carriers to stay safe other than calling 911.
We are very serious about the protection and security of our carriers, so this is our way of making sure that our carriers are safe, and hopefully the public can help us.
Police say community support can help keep mail carriers safe. Police ask if you see something suspicious to report it. Leaf pickup is officially complete in St. Joseph County, but county officials say there are still some stray leaves that could create issues. According to our reporting partners at the South Bend Tribune, county highway employees will be collecting leaves that could cause plowing issues. At this time, it's unclear where those locations are or when this will happen. All areas of the county received two passes earlier this year. Some major shopping frustrations at one of the nation's largest grocery stores. Credit and debit card machines going down yesterday at Kroger locations across the nation. The technical glitch left thousands of customers waiting in lines that are very long on Christmas Eve. They were forced to pay with cash or check. Kroger says the system was down for a short time, but was later restored. A time to give back to those in need in our area. The South Bend Soup Kitchen continuing its annual Christmas Eve tradition of gathering volunteers and passing out a hot meal. Volunteers served 450 guests ham, turkey, stuffing, potatoes, and lots of sweet treats. The kitchen says the holidays allow more people to volunteer their time. A generous donation from First Source Bank made the meal possible. A Christmas miracle in Lansing, Michigan, a critically endangered black rhino calf was born at Porter Park Zoo. It's the first time in the zoo's 100-year history that a black rhino has been born there. The zoo said in a press release the calf appears healthy but won't be on public display until spring of next year. Until then, you can keep up with the little guy on the zoo's Facebook and Instagram pages. Time is now 6:36. Cashing in on the holidays. Coming up, why a grandma in the United Kingdom is charging her family $45 each to attend her Christmas dinner. And the average American gains at least a pound during the holiday season. But still ahead, how a cup of Joe a day could help you lose weight.
And we're talking the warmest Christmas since the early 1980s. Remarkable warmth. We'll chat about how long that lasts coming up next.